Hi everyone, Johnny here for Chaos Cards, and today we are going to be opening up the new two-player starter for Star Wars Unlimited. It is Shadows of the Galaxy. It is the second set for Star Wars Unlimited. We're going to open up the two-player starter set, show you exactly what you're going to find inside, but make sure to head on over to the Chaos Cards online store and the TikTok shop and check out everything we've got Star Wars Unlimited, as well as many other brands we have over there too. We got some LIGO, we got some Yu-Gi-Oh! Magic, Pokemon as well, so much more. But of course, check out Star Wars Unlimited. Let's head down to the top down, show you what you can get inside this beautiful box. Right, so we got the two-player starter here for Star Wars Unlimited, Shadows of the Galaxy. Second set for Star Wars Unlimited, the trading card game. Another starter set, this one featuring Moff Gideon and the Mandalorian. Decks dedicated to each. And all you need to pick up Star Wars Unlimited is this beautiful two-player starter set. There is everything two players need to get playing with straight away. And to top it all off, there are exclusive cards in these starter decks that are not available in the set, not available in the booster boxes and the booster packs that you can pick up as well to complete your collection, to build your decks, to make the most powerful Star Wars Unlimited deck that you can. But there's some exclusives in this set, which is absolutely beautiful. It's very lovely. So you can see the deck lists here on the back of that too. You've also got all the tokens that you need to play the game as well. So let's get into it. So inside, you have your tokens. So your damage tokens, your epic action is done token, and your initiative token, which is very lovely. We've got the lovely quick start rules with a keyword glossary on the back, which is very handy. There's some new keywords in this second set, but it's also got instructions of how to play with any of the releases from Spark of the Rebellion as well, but new keywords such as bounty and smuggle available on this glossary too. We've got the deck boxes that you can put together. So there's a Mando one and a Moff Gideon one, and they're very simple to put together. All you have to do is just make sure that bottom bit is all done like that. You got this bit, you got that bit, you got this bit. This is a good detailed guide. I hope you're all paying attention. And there you go, deck box done. Very simple deck box that you can store this deck in or any other deck you've got available. I believe they will do sleeve cards as well. We've got the kind of posters, but they're not just posters. So you got a lovely poster there of Moff Gideon with Stormtroopers and Death Trooper, but also you've got the kind of layout for all where everything goes, basically, and some lovely helpful hints if you've not played the game before, add a reference there too. So really handy paper playmats, and there's exactly the same one for Mando, just with Mando on the kind of poster side here. Eventually, let me get it open. There you go. It's got Mando there too. No Grogu, but you've got the same playmat on that side, which is very handy for new players. And then of course we've got our two decks. So let's get into the Moff Gideon one first. Now, from what I've heard, from the stories I've heard, the Moff Gideon one is really good. And we'll go through vaguely the rules as well. But you've got your leader card here. So this is Moff Gideon, Imperial Official there. Has an action, you exhaust him, and attack with a unit that costs 3 or less. If it's attacking a unit, it gets +1 attack, +0 HP for this attack. But it has an epic action. So if you ever control 5 or more resources, which you'll be using to pay for the costs of everything that you put out, you deploy this leader. Now, that doesn't cost the resources, it just is a check to see if you have 5 or not, and then you can use the epic action, which means you can only use it once per game, to flip him, ready him, and move him to the ground arena, which is this side here. So you've got the cost, you've got the attack, and you've got the HP. Overwhelm, so when attacking an enemy unit, deal excess damage to the opponent's base, and each friendly unit that costs 3 or less gets +1 and +0, and gains overwhelm while attacking an enemy unit as well, which is a very fantastic ability. But this is an example of what basically every card will look like in Star Wars Unlimited for the most part. It's got the cost, it's got attack and HP if it's a unit, but it's also got the different kind of aspects you've got on the side when deck building there too. It says it's a leader unit and is goes in the ground arena. So in Star Wars Unlimited, you have the ground arena and the space arena, and the two kind of arenas of combat that you're going to have to fight in before you can defeat your opponent's base, which is the aim of the game. So in this case, Moff Gideon's base here is a Remnant Science facility on Navarro. It just has 30 hit points. It doesn't have any other special abilities, but it does change the deck building. So you've got the green and the blue, and then you've got the villainy aspect there as well. And that is the kind of the things that you you use when deck building. Now you can play things out of those two aspects, out of those three aspects. It just costs you two more to play each card. But what is lovely on here is you've got the deck list on the back. It tells you which things are in the set and which things, the S1s, are only available in the starter set. So for example, this Moff Gideon is only available in the starter set. So if you want to play Moff Gideon, this is the only place you can find him, as well as a load of these other things too, but potentially as a single card as well. Right, so we've got the base, we've got the leader, we've got tokens here as well. Now these tokens are really cool, because they just act as a +1/+1, which something may put on. So experience as an example, and then you've got a shield, which basically soaks up all damage from one attack, which is very lovely. Each shield does, but they can be used as attachments. So you can just chuck them under your dude like that. Or you can pick up those premium tokens, which I think are flowing in and out of stock, but there are lovely tokens that you can pick up. What is really cool though, is that they are different art from set one. So maybe this is something they're going to carry on. Every set's going to have new art to it for all of these tokens. This experience token does not look like the experience token from Spark of Rebellion, which is quite cool. So there's three of those token cards. So then we get into the deck itself. We get into the units and the events and such too. So we got a Warzone Lieutenant who costs one and has two attack, two hit points, no effect. Very easy. Lovely stuff. So you got a couple of those. You got Dr. Pershing. So Dr. Pershing here, two cost, zero attack, five hit points, is Imperial traded, and as an action can exhaust, deal damage to a friendly unit, but lets you draw a card. Fantastic ability, lovely stuff. We got General Tay, who I think was in the first set as a starter, maybe. I think so. But General Tay here is two cost, two attack, two hit points, and when played, give an experience token to up to each of three trooper units, which is absolutely fantastic. There we have an incinerator trooper here, two cost, two attack, two hit points, and while attacking this unit, deals combat damage before the defender. So if the defender is defeated in that combat, this incinerator trooper will take no damage in return, which is very lovely. Love that stuff. We got three of those. Outland Tie Vanguard, so two cost, two attack, one hit point. When played, you may give an experience token to another unit that costs three or less. That's absolutely fantastic. So we're getting those space units there too, so you got three of those. Privateer Crew, two cost, two attack, two hit points. Now this one has the new Smuggle keyword, which it's got Smuggle and then six and green. So if this card is a resource, you may play it for its Smuggle cost, which is six, and it's green as well, just to make sure that you have that aspect, or you need to pay more if you don't have that aspect. So if this card is a resource, so face down in your area, in your resource area, which will be exhausting to play cards. If it's face down as a resource, you may play it for its Smuggle cost here, but then you replace it with the top card of your deck. So you don't lose any resources essentially, or you lose one, but you gain one back. But you've got your Privateer Crew out. Now, that may seem a bit bad. So two cost and then six cost if you smuggle it. However, when played using Smuggle, you get to give three experience tokens to this unit. So it's getting +3/+3, which makes it an even better unit. So you got one of those. Seasoned Shore Trooper, two cost, two attack, three health. While you control six or more resources, this unit gets +2 attack. Fantastic. You got three of those. Snow Trooper Lieutenant, two cost, two attack, two hit points. When played, you may attack with a unit. If it's an Imperial unit, it gets +2 attack for this attack. You can only attack with a ready friendly unit, by the way. Very important to note. So you got two of those. Cell Block Guard, three cost, three attack, three hit points, and has Sentinel, which means the units in this arena, so if you're in the ground arena, which you will be, units in this arena can't attack your non-Sentinel units or your base, so they have to attack the Cell Block Guard if they would like to attack. So there's two of those. Death Trooper here, three cost, three attack, three health. When played, deal two damage to a friendly ground unit and two damage to an enemy ground unit. So three of those. Three cost, phase three Dark Trooper, three attack, three hit points, has Sentinel, and when combat damage is dealt to this unit, he gets an experience token, which is very nice if it survives the damage. So that's very cool. And there's three of those. Two plays Technician, three cost, two attack, one hit point. When defeated, you may put this unit into play as a resource and ready it, which is great. Great, I don't know, what's the word? Resourcing? Three of those. We have the Client here, three cost, two attack, five hit points, Werner Herzog there. Shielded, which I believe means it comes in with a shield, but let's check our handy guide. Shielded, when you play this unit, give a shield token to it. I know card games. So we got the client, dictated by discretion. So comes in with a shield, and as an action, you can exhaust the client to choose a unit. So that's any unit. For this phase, gains a bounty, heal 5 damage from a base. So when that unit is defeated or captured, its opponent collects its bounty. So ideally, you're putting that on your opponent's units. And then you defeat that unit, and then you get to heal 5 damage from your base, which is very nice, one of those. It's also a unique character, which is very important. We got Kirazi. Heavy fighter, 4 cost, 3 attack, 3 hit points. Overwhelm, so when attacking an enemy unit, deal excess damage to the opponent's base, like with Moff Gideon. And then on attack, you can exhaust another friendly unit. If you do this attack, gets plus 3 for this attack, so it does a bit more. One of those. We got System Patrol Craft, 4 cost, 3 attack, 4 hit points, and has Sentinel, which is very lovely. So you got 2 of those. 5 cost, Discerning Veteran, 3 attack, 4 hit points, and when played, this unit captures an enemy non-leader ground unit. So this is a bounty hunter here. This unit, so put the captured card face down under this unit until this unit leaves play. So capturing is essentially just capturing it under this card. So they're out of play until you defeat the bounty hunter. We have a Pirate's Battle Tank, 6 cost, 4 attack, 6 hit points. Has Sentinel as well, which is very nice, and has Smuggle here too, so you can pay it for 7 cost, but has these same aspects there as well. 2 of those. Gideon's Light Cruiser, so this is another starter exclusive one, 8 cost, 7 attack, 8 hit points, has Overwhelm, and when played, if you control Moff Gideon as a leader or a unit, which is very interesting, play a villainy unit that costs 3 or less from your hand or discard pile for 3. Let me guess that the Phase 3 Dark Troopers are 3 cost or less. What do I know? What do I know? And there's some lovely theme going on there, which is very cool. But also the Death Troopers are 3 cost or less too. So you can get those out for free when played if they're in your discard, which is very nice. There are 3 of those in this deck. We have Top Target here. So this is an upgrade. 1 cost. Attached unit gains bounty, heal 4 damage from a unit or base. If this unit is unique, heal 6 damage instead. So you're putting that bounty on your opponent, and when you defeat that opponent's unit, you also get the additional bounty reward, which is very lovely. So there's one of those. We have Legal Authority, 2 cost, upgrade again, attached to a friendly unit, so you have to put it on one of yours. When played, attached unit captures an enemy non-leader unit with less power than it. Very nice. And it also gives him plus 2 hit points, which is very cool too. You know, the authority is adding more hit points to your unit. 2 cost, price on your head. Attached unit gains bounty. Put the top card of your deck into play as a resource. So when you defeat a unit, you'll get another resource, which is essentially like getting money from succeeding in a bounty. So there's 2 of those. We have Outflank, 1 cost. Attack with 2 units, 1 at a time. So normally in a game of Star Wars Unlimited, you have 1 action and then your opponent does an action, and then you have 1 action and then your opponent does an action, and you go back and forth. So this Outflank lets you attack with 2 units, 1 at a time. So right at the beginning of the turn, if you're really worried about an opponent's unit getting an attack off, you can potentially deal 2 attacks to that same unit, get them out of there before they even have the opportunity, which is a very lovely card, one of those. Timing Intervention, 1 cost. Play a unit from your hand, give it ambush this phase, so it comes into play ready, and it may ready and attack an enemy unit. And then also this has Smuggle here too. So you can have it as a resource, but then you can play it there too, which is very lovely for just 1 extra cost. We have Confiscate, 1 cost, defeat and upgrade, very lovely. There's 2 of those. 3 cost, Moment of Glory, give a unit +4/+4 for this phase. Trejo! Right. 4 cost. Calculated lethality. Defeat a non-leader unit that costs 3 or less. For each upgrade that was on that unit, give an experience token to a friendly unit. That is very interesting, because if I'm reading this correctly, I can defeat some of my own units that maybe have a load of experience, like a Dark Trooper, and then give that to a friendly unit, potentially. We got 3 of those. And then finally, we have Remnant Reserves, 4 costs. Search the top 5 cards of your deck for up to 3 units, reveal them, and draw them. Amazing. Fantastic card there. 4 cost. Just get all your Stormtroopers in your deck, in your hand. Very lovely stuff. But that is what's in Moff Gideon's deck. Let's have a look and see what is in the Mandalorian's deck. So like with Moff Gideon, we have the Mandalorian as a leader here. So we have the undeployed side. When you play an upgrade, you may exhaust this leader. If you do, exhaust an enemy unit with 4 or less remaining hit points. And then if you control 6 or more resources, you deploy Mando here. Sworn to the Creed, 4 attacks, 7 hit points. And when you play an upgrade, you may exhaust an enemy unit with 6 or less remaining hit points. So exhausting your enemy units so they can't attack, essentially, which is quite nice. We have Remote Village here too on Sorgan. 30 hit points, and then again, you've got the checklist here, so you can see what comes in the starter set exclusively and what is available in the set. There too. We have our 3 tokens again, same as the other ones. And then we get into the cards. So we have a Clan Ren Rescuer, 2 cost, 1 attack, 2 hit points. When played, give an experience token to a unit. That counts as an upgrade. We've got 2 of those. Follower of the Way, 2 cost, 1 attack, 3 hit points. While this unit is upgraded, it gets +1/+1. Very lovely, so you're getting even more benefits. So the upgrade, like the experience token, for example, which is a token upgrade, will give it +1/+1, and then it gets an additional +1/+1 there too. So it's even more benefits for having more of those upgrades. So there's 3 of those. We have Grief Karga here, 2 cost, 2 attack, 2 hit points. When played, search top 5 cards of your deck for an upgrade, reveal it and draw it. Very nice, very upgrade heavy, of course. This is what we're finding out here. 3 of those. We have Grogu, irresistible apparently. 2 cost, 0 attack, 5 hit points. And as an action, you can exhaust Grogu to exhaust an enemy unit. So upgrades and exhausting. That's what this deck wants to do apparently. 3 of those. We have Queel, I Have Spoken. 2 cost, 2 attack, 3 hit points. Restore 1. So when this unit attacks, you get to heal the damage from your base, which is cool. Then on attack, discard a card from your deck. If it shares an aspect with your base, you get to return it to your hand. That is quite interesting, a card there as well. I guess that incentivizes having more blue cards in this deck. So 1 Queel. We have a Hawk, 290 Freighter, 3 cost, 2 attack, 5 hit points. So there's 3 of those. Mandalorian Warrior, 3 cost, 3 attack, 3 hit points. And when played, you may give an experience token to another Mandalorian unit. Again, another upgrade there, which is very lovely. So you've got 1 of those. Protector of the Throne, 3 cost, 2 attack, 4 hit points. While this unit is upgraded, it gains Sentinel. So if it's got an experience token, it also gets Sentinel, which is very cool as well. Don't know if you were about during Mando's time, but hey, I appreciate your armor. It's very cool. 2 cost. Village Protectors, 3 cost, 2 attack, 2 hit points, has Sentinel already, and Shielded too. So is another fantastic card here, because those shields soak up all damage. Every 1 shield soaks up every little bit of damage from 1 attack. So that's 3 cost there. Chain Code Collector, 4 cost, 4 attack, 2 hit points, has Ambush, so it may ready and attack an enemy unit. And then on attack, if the defender has a bounty, it gets -4/-0 for this attack. So it basically does less damage back to you, because when everything attacks, you attack each other at the same time. So that's really cool. 2 of those. We have the Razor Crest, Reliable Gunship. I think it blew up. 4 cost, 3 attack, 4 hit points. Restore 2, so when this unit attacks, heal 2 damage from your base. When played, you may return an upgrade from your discard pile to your hands. Get more of those upgrades back. 3 of those. We have Survivor's Gauntlet, 5 cost, 4 attack, 6 hit points. When played and on attack, you may attach an upgrade on a unit to another eligible unit controlled by the same player, which is very lovely. We have a 5 cost in the Armorer here. Survival is Strength, 3 attack, 5 hit points. And when played, give a shield token to each of up to 3 Mandalorian units, because she makes all that armor. There's 1 of those. Cargo Juggernaut, 6 cost, 4 attack, 6 hit points. Has Shielded, so comes in with that lovely shield. And when played, if you control another blue unit, you get to heal 4 damage from your base. 1 of those. We have Fennec Shand, Loyal Sharpshooter, 7 cost, 4 attack, 6 hit points. Ambush. And on attack, deal a damage to the defender if it's a unit for each different cost among cards in your discard pile. So getting more of that free damage, which is very lovely. So 1 of those. Public Enemy, 0 cost, is a bounty upgrade. So attached unit gains a bounty, give a shield token to a unit. Very lovely. We have 1 of those. Wanted, attached unit gets bounty, ready to friendly resources. So when you defeat it, you get to ready to resources. Very lovely. I'm loving all these different themed things for these bounty cards. 2 of those. And we have Foundling here, 1 cost. Attached unit gains the Mandalorian trait and +1/+1. And of course, if you want to play it thematically, you attach this to Grogu too, although I think it's probably better on some other Mandalorian units. Although Grogu would get the Mandalorian trait, which is quite nice. So there's two of those. Resilient, one cost, zero attack, but gains plus 3 hit points. So there's two of those. Rich Reward, one cost, is another bounty here. And when you succeed on that bounty, give an experience token to each of up to 2 units. So that's very cool, 2 cost. Snapshot Reflex is one cost, plus 1 attack, plus 1 hit point. And when played, you can attack with the attached unit, but it can only attack if it's ready. But that's essentially, again, getting 2 actions out of 1 card because you're playing it onto something and then they're attacking, which is very nice. 2 of those. Vambrace Grapple Shot, 2 cost, 2 attack, 2 hit points. Attach it only to a non-vehicle unit, and an attached unit gains this ability, which is on attack, exhaust the defender, which can be very lovely because you're attacking something and then they're exhausting, so they can't attack back as a separate action in that round. So one of those. Mandalorian Armor, 2 cost upgrade, gives you plus 1 attack, plus 3 hit points, can only be attached to a non-vehicle unit, but when played, if the attached unit is a Mandalorian, give a shield token to you. So you're adding up all these upgrades, you're getting a shield, you're getting another plus 1, plus 3, you're getting so many fantastic things. One of those. We have the Mandalorian's Rifle, so this is another exclusive card to the starter set. 3 cost, 3 attack, plus 0 hit points, can only be attached to a non-vehicle unit, and when played, if the attached unit is the Mandalorian, he gets to capture an exhausted enemy non-leader unit, which can be very lovely in getting some of those cards that may be a bit nasty out of the way for now. So there's 3 of those. Surprise Strike, 2 cost. Attack with the unit, it gets plus 3, plus 0 for this attack, which is very nice, one of those. This Is the Way, 2 cost. Search the top 8 cards of your deck for up to 2 Mandalorian and or upgrade cards. Reveal them and draw them. That's a great card, very versatile there too. One of those. Spare the Target, 3 cost. Return an enemy non-leader unit to its owner's hand. Collect that unit's bounties. That's very lovely. So you get to just, you know, 3 cost, get rid of a non-leader unit, but then you get the bounty on it too, which is very nice. There's one of those. And Fell the Dragon, last card in this deck, 4 cost, defeat a non-leader unit with 5 or more power. Very nice. Let's guess that the Crate Dragon has more than that, probably like 7 or something. Very lovely card there, Fell the Dragon. And that is what is in the Mandalorian's deck. And that as a whole is what you can find in the 2-player starter decks for Star Wars Unlimited, Shadows of the Galaxy. Make sure to send it over to the TikTok shop and the online store. That's chaoscards.co.uk. And over there, we've got loads of different Star Wars Unlimited bits, accessories. We got sleeves, we got boxes, we got cards, we got singles, we got booster boxes, booster packs, 2-player starter decks, so much more for Star Wars Unlimited. And we're very excited for this new set, Shadows of the Galaxy. We're exploring it, and make sure to keep your eyes peeled for the single cards that will be available very, very soon, so you can build whatever deck you're after, complete your collection, and so much more. So thank you for watching this video. I've been Johnny for Chaos Cards, and I will see you next time.